Hi, it's Ashley from Sweet Dreams Bake Shop, and welcome back to my channel where I make a lot of cake and cookie decorating tutorials. And today I have a very special guest, my best friend Rachel, who decided to make a super over-the-top cake for my kids. And if you've seen my channel before, then you've probably seen Rachel. She owns Happy Cakes, which is a local bakery, and she's also a Food Network champion. So make sure that you go and check out her Instagram, which I have right there down below. I think it is so invaluable to look at how other people decorate. You guys know I very rarely actually pipe my fillings. Rachel loves to pipe her fillings, and today she is using an American buttercream. I baked these chocolate cakes, and I actually used a bit of a different recipe. It was a recipe that said it was the best chocolate cake ever. I'm always a little bit skeptical when things use a superlative like that. However, I must say this was a very, very delicious chocolate cake. So when I first started my channel, and for a whole year, you guys basically saw me decorating and making things all on my own. But realistically, I actually bake a lot with Rachel, and we decorate a whole bunch together. She is at my house constantly, but of course, in 2020, she couldn't really be at my house. So that's why we're seeing a lot more content with Rachel in it, and I'm so excited for all the things that we have in the future to show you guys as well. But this is a very, very typical scene where I will be working on cookies, and she's working on cake, and we're honestly just doing this purely for fun. Make sure you stay till the end where you can see both my kids' and my friends' kids' reactions to this lovely cake. Now, no word of a lie, when I was editing this footage, usually I have to scroll past a lot of things when I'm editing my own decorating footage, but Rachel is so quick, and you can really see the finesse in everything she does, and she rarely has to do things more than once, which is how she actually finished this cake in 45 minutes, which is, you know, just incredible. So after she put in all of these supports, she made sure to clip everything down to size. Now, honestly, that center support is probably not needed at all since we're not going to be moving this cake very far. But if you are ever traveling with your cake or if you're giving the cake to a customer, that center dowel is super, super important just to make sure that nothing slides. As a side note, during this time, we were going to have a big dinner with a bunch of friends, you know, one of those gatherings that just started getting bigger and bigger the more you said, oh, sure, come on over. And so we were decorating super, super quickly. I was doing my cookies quickly, and she was working on this cake fairly quickly as well. And since things were a little bit busy and a little bit chaotic, we didn't realize that the camera had run out of battery, so we missed that stacking portion. But knowing Rachel, I'm sure she just picked it up with her hands, put it directly on there, but not fully coated or anything. She probably put this on crumb coated, and then she put the outer layer on. You'll notice that she decorated it as it was tiered. If we don't have the luxury of making sure that this is fully coated and super, super cold straight from the fridge, then what we have to do is place it on after it's been crumb coated and fairly solid, and then place it on the cake. Because if we try to do it the other way around, we're going to get fingerprints in that buttercream. There's really no way to transfer that buttercream cake smoothly, unless you do that little chopstick trick that I've shown you guys in other videos where you stab that big dowel right at the top of the cake and then you place it on. But that is a little bit of a riskier way to transfer, and that just isn't Rachel's style, so that is why she's doing it this way. For that big fluffy border there, she used a classic 1M tip. She put some sprinkles on there, and now she's using some candy melts to do this drip. You could also do this with a white chocolate ganache drip, whatever you please. And in order to get that really nice drippy texture, as I learned from Rachel, she adds a flavorless oil in there so that it's nice and drippy. The next step is to add on all of those little sprinkles, and I generally like to do this when it's a little bit tacky but not super, super loose. If you're doing it while the chocolate is still dripping down, you're gonna end up with sprinkles everywhere. You can also do this with tweezers. I do find personally that I have a little bit more control doing it with my fingers. It really depends what it is when you're doing fine work. Now is the fun part. We put that giant lollipop right in there, that lollipop, and all of the candies on this cake are from that candy store that I showed you guys previously in the introduction. I also made these mini cupcakes as well, and I will say I will link down in the description box below that perfect chocolate cake recipe that I used, and I only needed to use one batch of the recipe for this whole cake plus all of the mini cupcakes. Now, there's a couple tips that I can give you whenever you're creating a candy explosion cake. One of them being is you want to have lots of different heights and lots of different types of goodies. So I always like to keep macarons on hand. You guys know this. So that is definitely something that I would add. And as well, I added on those mini cupcakes just to give it a little bit more whim. And of course, we have one big lollipop. You don't want more than one big lollipop because it's going to start weighing everything down. Now, the other thing is we want to create varying heights. So I had suggested to Rachel that we take those little pieces of rainbow striped candy and we kind of place them on a stick of some sort just to give it that little bit of whim and height and make things look more interesting. Now, I personally love something like meringues on a cake like this, but we didn't have any on hand. So I really love how Rachel added in all of those little swoops and different detailings with the buttercream. Again, super simple, using a closed star tip for some of those designs. And then we're going ahead and adding on a few more sprinkles and a few more pieces of chocolate. And now it's time for the big reveal. They just think they're getting a regular dessert. And of course, my son can't keep his eyes closed, but ta-da! I think they were truly excited with what we were presenting to them. I mean, how many times do you get to go to something that's not a birthday party and get a really over-the-top cake like this? Now, this cake can realistically feed way more than the number of children here, and you'll notice that we did leave that lollipop wrapped because I just felt like I don't think there's gonna be one single child that will be able to actually finish that. Now, I know some people get a little bit nervous cutting cakes like this, but because we've got that board in the middle, it really is just the same as cutting any other cake. There's just two tiers to it. And honestly, we didn't even make it through half of the top tier. So we've got a lot of cake left over. I wish I could share with all of you. Now let's get into the pricing of this cake. Pricing for this is going to be a little bit more complicated with my explanation, but basically if this was a custom order only, we would do this for $200 Canadian, but including all of the candy, because this is a 4 and a 6 inch, so it is a bit smaller. However, if we did this as a 6 and an 8 inch, but no candy provided, the customer would have to provide it themselves, it would be $200 Canadian. And as always, pricing differs all over the world, so I provide you guys my pricing so you can kind of look at all of my videos as a whole to see the differentiation between the types of cakes that we create on this channel. And location-wise, I would have to say that my cake pricing is pretty middle of the road for where we live. For our subscriber submission of the day, we have this awesome Spider-Man cake, and it actually looks like the eyes are glowing. Not sure how that was created, but super cool. Go and check out at My Royal Delights on Instagram, drop them a like, and go ahead and follow them. And if you want to be the next featured subscriber on my channel, make sure to follow me at SD Bake Shop on Instagram. Give me a tag on one of your photos that you want to share with me, or you can private message me as well. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe so you can be part of the Sweetie fam. Right now, I'm uploading weekly, so make sure you hit that notification bell so you know when I upload. Also, be sure to comment, request, or ask a question. I love hearing from you guys. Bye!